So I'm filming here with a GH5 here. This is nearly the launch day right here in the UK. And this is 150 megabit per second, 4K 60 frame per second. Awesome. Hello. So who are you?
Hey, I'm Kevin. I'm here with Panasonic playing with the GH5.
So there's a big photo show right now going on right here in the UK.
Yeah, it's at Birmingham NEC and it's the photography show live.
And this is the coolest camera that has ever been existed in the world? Or
well, we're glad that you think so. We've had a massive demand for this camera. You know, we've had huge, great insurgent from people where they love the GH4 and they wanted to progress with their kit. And GH5 does that.
So right here, I'm filming with a GH5 and it's the first time I'm using it, so I'm not like quite totally maybe an expert. Maybe you can take over. Why don't you take over? And I'll be holding it right here. Okay, now you're following me, right? Hey, what are you dressed like?
Sorry?
What is that?
This is a character for game called Dota.
Okay, cool. Let's walk over here.
Cool, man. Let's do it.
Thank you, Dave.
No problem.
All right, let's walk over here. So it feels like really nice to hold, I think. Can I do an interview with you? You want to be in video? All right. Check it out. So what are you dressed up like?
Fast game.
Characters from the show Fast Game.
Cool. Right now is what they call St. Patrick's Day, I think. And there's Comic-Con going on. Cool. Thanks a lot. Cool. Maybe I can grab it again. Let's try it again. There. All right. So it's got, I mean, this is going to be very interesting to see. It's got very good autofocus now, right? Much faster autofocus.
The reactions from this camera are absolutely incredible. The autofocus is instant. You're recording beyond broadcast quality on this kind of kit.
And the steady, this five-axis steady shot. Let's walk a little bit.
We're not using any rig here. You've got it handheld and you're walking. So you can see, you know, the stabilization works incredibly well. We're stabilizing in body and in lens.
And right now I'm using the Leica 12 to 60. Let's go over here and let's check these guys out.
Me, please.
Okay. You want two of these guys at the same time?
Fair enough.
All right. There's a lot of action going on. Hey, what are you, is this the Game of Thrones?
No, it's Justice League.
Cool. Thanks. All right. I think it looks great. And the steady seems very, very steady.
Yeah. You know, we've got a kit here that can broadcast. Only can do beyond broadcast quality. We can actually do 422 10-bit in body, which is, you know, setting the precedent of where we can take technology. On top of that, we can also do 6K photo. We can shoot at 30 frames a second and lift stills at 18 megapixels. But come on, let's have a little walk in. And what we'll do is have a look at the stand. Let's come find some people.
Let's go. Photography show had the neck.
Fingers crossed they let me in, yeah?
Yeah, and me too. Yeah. So I need to grab my my badge right here. Cool. Let's walk over here.
Hey. Thank you.
So at the photography show, they allow cameras, I hope.
They allow cameras and they allow us to film, which is a great privilege. But on top of that, it gives you the opportunity to get hands-on and actually be one of the first people to get hands-on with this kit and show people what it's actually capable of. How's it feel in the hand?
I'm not using any Steadicam at all. I'm just holding it like you're holding it right now. And it's very interesting to see how the performance is of this. It's what's called a contrast-based focus, right?
Yeah.
That is super fast now with a newer chip, right?
So we're using the Venus engine, and the fact is that actually, if you want to use depth of body focus, but it's incredibly fast. It will zoom all the way in and all the way out and get that focus point immediately. But hey, you can hear the music. Let's have a look at what's going on, yeah?
Let's go. Interesting to try the. So this should look like cinema.
it will look exactly like cinema. So what people are often using, so the BBC and other large corporations are using this cat to use inside cars for big car shows and everything else. On top of that, what you're finding is it's the versatility of the product. So whether you can put it in a drone or whatever you want to use it for. Actually on the stand, hopefully we'll be able to get hold of Nick Driftwood. Nick Driftwood is a pro cinematic producer, and he actually uses GH5 and GH4. He's progressed to GH5, and he's actually shooting in 6K and cropping down. So he's even taking what we're using for photography and taking that and using it as well. So cropping down to 4K. It's impressive stuff. Here we are. If you have a pan round, you can see our stand. You can see where we're going from here.
There's lots of people. I think I heard that 30,000 people coming to the show.
Well, looking at this, most of them are on our stand.
Yeah, there's lots of people at your stand. Is the main photography event in the UK?
Yes. So more people come here than any other show. And mainly because all the latest kits here. So you can actually come down, see the GH5, the 1-400 lens, all the things that people want to see and get their hands on, but can't in the general marketplace.
So they're trying all the... trying right here.
And then you can sew along and choose what you want.
Showing it off, so it's the best place to get hands-on in the UK. And how come are you launching during the show, basically? Is it a coincidence?
It's a pleasant coincidence. So normally what happens is we tend to kind of like slightly miss it. So we always end up launching a couple of weeks late. However, this year it's worked out perfectly. So we've managed to get a GH5 in every corner of the stand, which is perfect for us because it means that people can come down, see what we've got, and actually play with it.
Thanks. Looks very, very cool. All right. Let's check these guys right here. So,
we've managed to get Nick Driftwood here. Hopefully we can drag him off. Nick's the guy that we were talking about, where actually he's using the kit professionally. And you know, he's an ambassador. He's getting out there and really kind of using this kit to show his true potential and what it's actually capable of.
He's been using a pre-production model, right?
He's used a pre-production model. So he's progressed from GH4 to using pre-production models of GH5. To kind of make sure that everything works, make sure that when it hits the marketplace, it's all perfect and up to speed.
So maybe he's the guy at the booth that has the most experience with GH5.
He's the guy at the booth, and he's the guy at the booth that's got the most bits clipped onto one. So he's the guy that we need to grab hold of and have a look at what he's got.
Have a look at that.
What is that?
This is a 12K 360 rig using the Panasonic GH80 cameras with Eisoga lenses. Yes.
Is that the coolest quality 360 camera?
It's the best quality 360
the best,
camera.
Like the best in the world?
Yeah.
Do you get more than 4K out of this, right? You could get like 8K
12,
or...
12K.
12K 360.
4K every direction.
Yeah. 12K every direction. No, not quite that much, right? But so you put these videos on YouTube, and how do you merge?
We use AutoPanel Video Pro. That's stitching software. To stitch all the six cameras, similar to any other 360 stitching, apart from the quality of our videos is quite good.
Cool. Let's jump in.
120, I believe it. I still better check that. Same as my DVX200, it should be 120 frames. 0.05 of a second, done. 0.05 of a second.
Hi, so who are you?
I'm Nick Driftwood, who are you?
I'm Charbax from armdevices.net. So it's very nice to meet you. And you've been using the GH5 a little bit, right?
Yeah, I take it it's been okayed. I have been using the GH5 quite a lot. 3 months now I've had it, backwards and forwards. People have been borrowing them, begging them, stealing them.
Yeah.
You know. So, I love the camera. What do you want to know?
So it's like a very, very special camera, right? It has stuff that people are going crazy over.
This is the people's camera. It's a revolution. It's sub £2,000. There's not a camera like it specced out which can match it. 422 10-bit internal, better chroma subsampling. You've got over a billion colors of tonality, much more than the 16 million colors of tonality of all the other 8-bit cameras you see around here. And it can do it all internally, 422 10-bit. We've also got 50p, 60p at 4K and 180 frames per second slow-mo at a HD level, up to variable, so from 2 to 180. We've also got a high resolution anamorphic coming. It will do anamorphic like the GH4, and it'll also do it at 60p anamorphic in 4K.
Have you tried now, the anamorphic?
Yes, I use it all the time.
So that means a wide cinema style, right?
Because this is now pixel for pixel readout, yeah, at 4K, the GH4 was slightly cropped. This is the exact, so when I put a times 2 lens on, it literally is double the size. So when I de-squeeze it, the anamorphic picture, we're getting twice as wide shots.
So
CinemaScope.
So for what do you think about the autofocus now? You've been using G3, GH4, how is it operating now?
225 autofocus points. But I've got just checked on there, the go. 225 area.
I do filmmaking and music, so in some ways, it's just three of us.
Also, put on autofocus continuous. I want to now. You can put it on tracking. Do when you track someone around, half down the shutter, they're always in focus. Not only that, I've got dual image stabilization too, which means the lens and the body has got full image stabilization. I don't really need a gimbal anymore because it's so lightweight to use. It's just fantastic. So that's why I'm loving it.
Let me jump on this side. What do you think about autofocus and video?
Autofocus and video is brilliant. As I say, 0.05 video with Vlog. I've now got Vlog assist. I'm going to show you on my other camera. Let's borrow that. Over here, we've got a Metabone speed booster on, 0.71, with a Sigma Art 50mm lens, yeah? Now let's look at this, the autofocus speed, I'm bringing to my friend here, Kevin. I'll touch that, look how fast that autofocusing, 0.05 of a second. Nice bit of depth of field. I can change my settings on the Metabones. We've got a Vlog as well. When I change this mode now to movie making mode, now you can see a lovely grey Vlog. 4C Vlog L, but it's pretty similar to how it used to do, yeah. But we can set that up Vlog and see with a Vlog View Assist, we can load up to 4 different lookup tables.
So you can actually kind of like get a taste of how it's going to look like after you do the color correction later,
you
right?
You can see how it's going to look before you actually commit. So you don't have to commit it to the card or via the Shogun. You can burn it in with the Shogun. But with this, when you turn it on, you can see exactly what you're getting. So if you made a LUT or a look inside something like DaVinci Resolve, you can load the VLT off the SD card into the camera via this Vlog View Assist mode. LUT select, load it into set 1, 2, 3 or 4. So up to 4 different looks can be loaded up. If you haven't got one, you can always use the Vlog 709 look. Just so when it is turned on, you don't get the greys, you get the full colour look of whatever lookup table you've employed. Okay?
So you're not shooting some grey stuff when you do your Vlog mode,
I've already got grey log, and then I can see that when I do chop in there, you can see yeah, what I'm actually getting.
So have you done the coloring after? How does it look at the end?
Yeah, the Vlog, when I bring it into Resolve, I apply the same LUTs maybe, or even adjust it with more nodes and layer it up more until I'm happy with the look. Looks fantastic. 10-bit 42 is really, really good. But don't listen to what anyone else is saying. It's fantastic. Okay?
So 10-bit is a big deal.
Big deal.
Big deal.
Over a billion colors of tonality. You've also got better chroma subsampling, as I said. That's the chroma reds, the chroma blues. You've got both lines, 422, and full dithering of 422 10-bit inside the camera. You don't need the Atomos Shogun.
But if you don't do the coloring after post-processing, then the 10-bit maybe is not that useful. It's mostly for post-processing,
right? You only need to use it. Think about like skies, blue skies, the gradations, yeah? In 8-bits, often when it's quite a bright, the sun is out, and you're filming the blue skies, you might see stepping, yeah? You definitely see it on a 10-bit monitor. And we're all going 10-bit now. Monitors, TVs, PCs, we're all going the 10-bit way. We're moving away from 8-bit. So more and more people like you will be able to see that problematic stepping you get with 8-bit. We want pure gradations. We want better green screen, blue screen masking. And we can pull out the colors better. With 10-bit, obviously, we've got a much better chance of getting a better looking image.
Is this an HDR camera or not? Do 4K HDR?
It will do hybrid log gamma. We've got a new gamma curve coming out in the summer on a new firmware update. So you will be able to record hybrid log gamma images with this camera. So like we're doing with Vlog, it's a flat gamma curve where it meets an SD kind of curve. And that will formulate an HDR style or hybrid log gamma, we're calling it, but high dynamic range image, so you can record it for your TVs. And the great thing about HLG is it's backwards compatible, yeah? And I personally believe that's the way it's gonna go over things like Dolby Vision and the rivals, HLG10. So I think we're on the right track, definitely, with the hybrid log gamma we've got inside this camera.
And so this is a 60p HDR or 30 only?
HDR, high dynamic range. Well, yeah. It goes from 24, 25, 30, 50, 60, yeah?
And
I haven't tested high dynamic range out yet in terms of video with the hybrid log gamma because we haven't got it yet. So we don't know what level that will come out at. So I can't give you any clues.
And
sorry.
The other stuff that's coming with the 400 megabit, right? How useful is that?
The usefulness of that is you're getting all intra codec, yeah? Which temporal and spatial compression is much better than the Longot. We're getting 400 megabits. I believe it's going to be 8.264, but I haven't confirmed that yet. And I think that's going to look a lot better than what we're currently getting with the Longot. But having said that, the compression routines in here are absolutely phenomenal.
Am I wrong in wanting to see an option to have H.265 in 4K so I can upload it faster, so the file size would be smaller?
You're not wrong in wanting it. You never know, you might get it. We're changing over now to, you know, new compression like H.265 because, let's face it, as we go beyond 4K, because 4K limit is only H.264, it means we've got to go into H.265 territory. A lot of TVs, devices, cameras now are beginning to take on H.265. You know, we've been ratified now for over a year. Panasonic are at the forefront of that, and they are definitely, with a hybrid compression, H.264 and H.265, who knows what's going to happen. So watch this space.
So right now I've been filming for nearly 18 minutes, and it's not shutting down.
It shouldn't do, as long as your battery's charged.
There's no overheating, right? And your experience, none at all.
You've got extended, you can actually film away and record as long as you like, down to your battery or SD card limit. So the great thing is you've got hot swapping as well. Once one of the SD cards runs out, you can drop another card in and it'll swap between them, hot swapping them. So once your second card has run out, pull the top one out, change it over, simply done. You can direct videos to one card if you want and photographs to the other.
Yeah.
Very nice.
And I was wondering, the H.265 6K, have you used that? Are you able to use that format?
Yeah, you can see it.
Where do you put the 6K file?
Nick Driffel on YouTube, you can see a 9-minute video of 6K photo mode. Yeah.
9 minutes.
Being cropped, 9 minutes long. I've done it in DaVinci Resolve. I've done a cut showing you what it looks like. And it's an amazing 18.7 megapixels. You know what it is at 4x3. We're able to, each frame, so we're able to utilize that photographic mode as a filmmaker to actually record 30 frames per second video. And that I have used and is incredible image quality. The IQ on it is phenomenal to see. The resolution alone, it definitely needs to be seen. If you're filming like architecture, landscapes, or you're after detail, I really love the 6K photo mode. It's really lovely black, crushed blacks, fantastic crisp image quality. And then you can pan and scan or crop it rather, down to 4K, which I've done online on my YouTube channel, and I think you're gonna love it.
May I ask you, without stopping the video, are you able to disable the flickering that's going on right now?
Yeah,
I think it's
got the flicker correct, so I'm not gonna do that.
How do you do that? Can you do it on the camera?
Well,
you would have to stop the video? Okay.
I'm a little bit ill at the moment. Rather than carry all this swapping over, I can't do it. But you've got flicker removal. It looks at the shutter. Let me explain. It looks at the shutter, 50 shutter, you know, 100 shutter, 120, and then it'll see what kind of lighting or what frequency range you're in. Then it adapts it to, and it goes straight into being able to get rid of that flicker without you having to go into the angle setting. It's really a quick way of getting in there, but you can do it manually and fine-tune it with the angles as well.
All right, cool. So this is a really exciting camera, GH5, and
you've nearly expelled my voice, XLR. I'm going to have to stop.
Sorry, sorry. Cool. Dual XLR looks cool.
Yep.
Right there.
The XLR1, we can control the sound either manually, mono rather, on one channel, and copy both mono channels to over the both stereo spectrum, or we can crop down, plug in two microphones, one in the field, one close up, for example, and you can record at 96K 24 bits, 48K 24 bits, or 48K 16 bits. All good?